When the activity is sustained on the level of silence, then the activity is sustained on the level of all possibilities. Then the activity is sustained on the level of the basis of all the laws of nature. Basis of all the laws of nature is enlivened on that lively ground of all the laws of nature. Activity is sustained. Then what happens is, activity naturally is in accordance with all the laws of nature. And in this sense, activity is always evolutionary. Evolutionary activity does not meet with problems, with resistances, with failures. Now, this is a value which prompts us towards life free from problems, life free from suffering, life free from failures. If that silence could be sustained in the midst of activity, and it does begin to happen as the physiology is trained to maintain that silence in the midst of activity. It's a very beautiful state of awareness, and the chances are that whatever the genetic deficiencies, coming on to the genetic thing, whatever genetic deficiencies which would prompt a man to violate the laws of nature and not move straight on the path of evolution, in the direction of evolution, those deficiencies will remain dormant, and those values which are in favor of evolution, more positive values, they begin to function more and more and more and more. And the chances are, we'll have to go through experiments to establish it, the chances are that the deficiencies, the genetic deficiencies, are overcome. And a very profound, beautiful level of life, we may say ideal state of life, could be developed in the physiology. The experiments that have been performed so far are enough, even though they are yet to be supported and supplemented by further more experiments. But the direction that all of them give is very promising for mankind. And that is to eliminate weakness in human nature, which is not any aspect of human nature. It's a kind of weakness of human nature. Human nature essentially is that field of all possibilities. Another characteristic of that area is perfect orderliness. Perfect orderliness, no entropy. It's all infinite orderliness. And it is that being at the basis of all creation, everything is so orderly in nature. So this orderliness increases in life, and life becomes freer from problems, from weaknesses, from suffering, to eliminate suffering from life. Towards this direction, the experiments have shown enough promise.
Can I ask a question about the effect of meditation on the genetic material?
Yes, let's. Yes.
As I understood it, you were suggesting.
This was the most important answer.
I gather you were suggesting that not only does meditation affect physiology,
but
affect genetic material. Are you suggesting that it affects the information in the material, which is then carried on, so that a meditator produces a better offspring?
Information initially comes from the hereditary, from the DNA. But the environment, how the information is interpreted and passed on. So it is the environment that we think would be changing through this procedure. The information may remain the same.
Oh, good. So it's really not important for your philosophy, the information.
Yes, it doesn't matter what a man had been coming from the past. It's good enough that he had that nervous system and that mechanism where he can have that unbounded awareness. And from that level, the information, whatever is there, can only be utilized for evolution.
Does this mean it would be better...
Interpretation.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Does this mean then it would be better for a person to start as young as possible to meditate? Huh? So that's that as he develops...
As he comes to about measure about 21 or 18, he should be a fully developed mind, and that should mean that his thoughts and desires should be only life-supporting. Perfect orderliness, only life-supporting, and he must be able to fulfill all his desires without meeting resistances. Because the desires would be supported by all the laws of nature. That kind of training and habituation of the physiology must be brought about before a child becomes major. That's why we want to introduce in education. And this will mean a great degree of prevention would be achieved. Prevention from diseases. The whole immune system will be so strong that the any environment, he'll adjust to the environment. The whole system would adjust to the environment such that it will not entertain diseases, sicknesses.
And can I ask one final question about the role of experimentation? Do you see that simply as confirming what you already know?
Because we know what it is. The whole literature, the whole Vedic literature is there to say this is the entire thing is there. Only that has not been the common experience so far. So we bring it on the common experience level. And to show that the experiences are real and they are not just the moods or imaginations, not only psychological level, but they have a bearing on real transformation on the physical level. So we put these experiences and say that. This is the value of the experimentation.
Is it likely to go beyond that and tell you something that you don't know? In other words, is it productive as well as confirmatory?
Right. The thing is, all the literature has been there, it has been there. But the whole thing was unproductive. It just laid dormant. So we are just revising and renewing and proving it in the lives of the people, personal experience, and then supporting that personal experience from the objective measurements. So that without doubt we know that we are doing something very good for mankind. Every meditator, when he brings out one experience here, one experience there, he is adding to the value of the package of knowledge which he has received. And this is how the movement has grown from man to man, from man to man, like that. And when it was found to be so rewarding, then the interest of the scientists to see what is happening, after all, what is there in that region of biochemistry, this chemistry, in this physiology, in this. And as any scientist probes deep into his area, he comes out with some finding, By now this, and then the isolated experiments are one thing. But when we put all of them together and review them, then the holistic value that arises from the comparison of all the experiments is very, very rewarding. What has come out? All these professors from different areas sit together and then just talk. No matter from where the talk begins, but it ends up into some very marvelous conclusions. This is what we generally do whenever everyone feels bored with his isolated areas. We sit together and pick up certain, all these experiment distances. And then start reviewing them afresh. What has come out of this is so valuable. And it is these fundamentals, these fundamentals of education. Receptivity, intelligence, knowledge, experience, expression, these fundamentals. And then each of them develop on four levels, physiological level, psychological level, sociological, behavioral level, and ecological level. And these fundamentals then are a new contribution to the field of knowledge. That now these fundamentals have not been available in the field of education. That is why education has not been very fulfilling. Fundamentals of health have come out. Fundamentals of administration have come out. Fundamentals of communication have come out. And very, very beautiful aspects of knowledge, which will enrich the knowledge in every field and make it so complete that based on that knowledge, that area will be free from suffering and problems. Governments will be free from suffering and problems. All the health institutions, this environmental institutions, business, industry, all these areas will be free from problems because of these fundamentals developing in the life of the individual, developing in the life of the groups of individuals.